Gotta stay here. Swallow this.
Yep, swallow that guy right there.
So in the case of hot pits, does do the flagger?
Flaggers move to the other side.
Okay.
Alright, let's see if we can make this thing work. You get your pit, your track pass. Alright, now, try to stick this up in your helmet. Basically what I do is I just tuck it up in there. Kind of work the boom over. Check, check. Check, check, check.
Good check.
Check, check. Alright. Make it a little bit easier to hear.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Eventually I want to get the better one, but I thought I'd try this one. Yeah, it's not as durable as the other ones, but shit, for 65 versus 145. And you know I'm a cheap ass, so. But once you get all that wind whipping, it's hard to hear. Especially with cars going by and everything else. Oh, shit, Jeremy broke again. And that guy has rough luck. Last event out here, he put it in the wall. Been all winter rebuilding it. Hopefully it's something simple this time.
Kinks worked out maybe.
Yeah. Thank you. a little bit, we have to slow our brain down.
Sure.
Autocrossers make good road racers. Road racers make horrible autocrossers. Thank you.
temper switch.
Sure.
You're pumping others. You ramp it up, ramp it down. You want to turn on the back side of that cone.
Get close to that cone?
Yeah.
All right.
Back over here.
I really wanted to last year and thought my other car would be ready for it.
Yeah.
I was going to autocross this and track another, but this year I was like, I'm not going to put this off anymore.
Well, it'll ruin your autocross. It's just not quite as fun.
I figured it would be that way.
I mean, I still like the autocross.
Sure.
But it's something versus, 20 minutes on session. Let me tell you, by the end of the day, your last session,
You're
like, fuck. Your arms are going to be hurting, your hands are going to be tired from gripping the wheel.
Yeah. That's what I was expecting.
I mean, especially when it's, like right now, it feels pretty good. This afternoon, it's warmer, and you're sweating like a goat, man.
Yeah.
I mean, I've come off of a track in November, and it looks like it's August, man. It's just, I'm like wiping the sweat as I'm driving.
Yeah.
And it's just seat time.
Sure.
Seat time. And, learning. There's more to this. On paper, this looks so simple.
Oh, yeah.
But, like I said, on paper, that's 3 or 4 turns.
Right.
In real life, it's like 1.
Right.
And
right.
When you hit that arc just right, oh, hell yeah. Because yeah, you can
that's
carry.
That's how I felt in the carousel, just, you know, pushing, like you said, just one, you know, big turn. I don't know. And even coming through, starting the S's there, I don't know. That's interesting.
And it's, you know, just figuring out, okay, that's 290s.
Right.
You know, that's, no, it's kind of that.
Yeah.
You know, when you look at the line and you get it just right, it's more of like that. It's not bad, you know. And it's designed to trick you, you know.
Sure.
And, you know, like I said, the M. That, if you hit it right.
Yeah, I need to watch those cones.
And like I said, your brain is telling you, hug the inside, hug the inside, hug the inside. Because in all of our racing brain games and everything, you won't stay tight.
But if you take the first one tight, I guess you can come out of it. And
you have to give up the first one.
Yeah.
To get two and three.
Right, right.
And that's one of the things that you won't give up.
Right.
Once you start, okay, I got to give up one to set me up for two and three. Because
right.
You can blast into one and two. And then you are pooched for three.
Right.
And if
that's usually what I did in the autocross.
If you're pooched for three, you can carry no speed down that straight.
Right.
Just
yeah,
like
that's important. It's coming out of that.
Just like here. If you can get your exit out onto here right, you by the 10, 12 miles an hour at the end of the straight.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a lot of time.
I mean, and like I said, once you get it, you know, I'm saying 10, 12 in my piece of shit. You know? Because, I mean, there's a difference where I'll be shifting into fourth as soon as I get on the track.
Okay.
You
that's
know?
What Mike was saying.
And, you know, and like I said, it's going to depend on your car and your gearing. Like, my car will be, I'll be fourth shifting into fifth going up to the carousel. I'll get it back into third in the carousel, and my car will stay in third. I'm trying to think, do I get fourth? I'll get back into fourth. Because, like I said, coming into the dog leg, as we're, like where track out is, I'm flat on the floor.
Right.
And that's probably almost my fastest section of the course.
Okay.
Because I got some downhill.
Right.
You know, running up this strip, shit, that just, I'm checking my watch, I'm watching, you know, make a couple texts. I like better when we go down hot pits.
Okay.
Because it adds more to the track.
Right.
And the higher power cars can't walk off from it.
It's a good point. It's a good point.
I like it. And I'm stupid and ballsy enough to take the exit full speed.
Okay.
Everybody else kind of backs off going through that opening.
And I will say, like, some of these turns, that's where I'm at with this car. I'm afraid to drive fast and turn it. Like, over there near me and Tal, like on Perkins, I was going, like, 25. And I spun this through there. Of course, it was like, you know, the tires that came on it when I bought it. But ever since then, I'm just like, you know, this is not my Honda. And I don't know, it's tough. Like, you know, telling my brain, like, okay, you know, push it. And I don't know. There's a big gap there between thinking about it and doing it.
Well,
but.
And this is a completely different animal than a Honda.
Yeah.
You know, and you're going to spin.
Sure.
That's when you know that's my edge.
Right. Right.
And you know, you don't want to go out and spin every damn corner.
Right.
But you'll start to where you'll spin one or two, and it's like, okay, that's as far as that. Well, that's as much angle as I can get on that.
Yeah.
But the thing is, it's just work your way up to it. Don't make yourself uncomfortable. And when you're not on track, in order to scoop cloud session. Be setting up in different corners, watching, you know, watching different lines.
Yeah, I've been down the steps up here.
Watching this is a good one. Watching the 90s is a good one. You can go down to Tech and watch the Elms, but that's, the perspective is a little bit different, but it still kind of gives you, that's, you watch there, you know, and it's just figuring out where your car likes to be.
Right.
You know, some cars want to be tight on the inside on the carousel, some need to go up a little bit.
Yeah.
And
okay.
It's just kind of try this line, move over a half of a car lane.
Yeah.
And you're just, that's all you're doing.
That's what I've been doing, is watching y'all's GoPro videos on YouTube. And,
okay, go and watch me driving my Honda, watch Drew driving my Honda.
Okay.
Two completely different lines.
Yeah, that's a good point. I haven't thought to do that.
That's where I feel the car's better.
Yeah.
That's where he feels the car's better.
Right.
He's a little bit crazier and harder on it than I am. I guess because I have to fix it.
Sure.
But, I mean, it's just, you know, in track conditions, the track's going to warm up. Yeah. It's going to get stickier.
Right.
You can push it.
Right.
Watch your tires. The track's good about chewing up the tires, but you never know. Right. Check your, just give them a good look over after every session.
Yeah.
Make sure you're not wearing weird or starting to chunk or you're rolling right over and, you know, I've come off and I've cornered the inside of the tire and I didn't even realize it. So, you know, it's just, but yeah, just, I mean, you're good, you're calm, you're, you know, so just.
Yeah, I don't know, I'm probably as comfortable as I could be. I mean, I don't know, like you said, you know, I'm still kind of pushing the limits of the car and getting comfortable there.
One thing you got to is the inputs.
Right.
Ease in, ease out. You know, we're off and on autocross.
Right.
Ease in and ease out, because getting this car, like going through that carousel, mm-hmm. once you get it, once you start your turn in, that car should be planted. There shouldn't be any of that. Once you get that, that's when you get that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this car doesn't like that.
Yeah, exactly. So, like I said, just get it like that. You know, it's learning.
Right.
Know? Okay, I'm going a little too fast. I can back off, but instead of...
Right.
Yeah. And that's all it usually takes is just a touchback.
Right.
Not coming full off like we do normally. Time for next session, do we know?
Oh yeah, that's where I'm headed next weekend.